In today's video, I'll be sharing the recipe of a very exotic veg curry of Indian cuisine that's called gram flour or besan curry. Very traditional and has a very unique flavor. So when you want to try something exotic on veg items, try this recipe and let me know. Hey guys, I'm Subhankari and I welcome you all to my channel Source Food Corner. I hope you all are doing great in your lives, and if you're new to my page, do subscribe to my page and don't forget to tap the bell button. Thank you all for loving my channel so much and liking my videos so much. So let's begin with this awesome recipe. So for this besan or gram flour curry, I have taken here 1 cup of besan. It's the fine one, it's always available and is used in many ways. So 1 cup of besan and salt 1 teaspoon I have added. To it I'll add turmeric powder 1 teaspoon, red chili powder 1/2 teaspoon and hing or asafoetida around 1/2 a teaspoon. This gives a very nice balanced flavor. So first, the trick here is that we need to nicely mix all the dry ingredients. So I'll first mix them in this way, and then I have taken water 1.5 cup. For this is the trick to a perfect besan curry. So for perfect tikkis, we need, the ratio is for 1 cup of besan, 1.5 cups of water, but that I will add gradually. 1/2 a cup I'll add at this stage, or just little than 1/2 a cup to make a nice smooth batter. So I'll mix in one direction, and you can see now with little bit amount of water the batter is perfectly smooth in this way. After the batter has attained this stage, I'll add the rest of the water. So rest of the water goes here. So for 1 cup of besan or gram flour, I have taken here around 1.5 cups of water. For that will make the perfect besan tikkis. Just give it a mix and just rest for around 2 to 3 minutes, that's it. So our besan mixture for the tikkis are ready. For the next stage, I have taken a frying pan heated in medium high flame. Once it is heated in medium high flame, I'll add oil 1 tablespoon, and then to it I'll add the entire prepared mixture of the besan and start stirring it in medium flame for around 3 to 4 minutes, and you will notice it will start to thicken. So there is nothing to worry about, we just want a nice thickened cooked base of this besan. So after 5 minutes you can see, as because we are stirring continuously, it has attained a nice smooth texture. This is what we want. We don't want lumpy mixture, we want a very nice and smooth mixture. This is it has started to thicken perfectly, and after again roasting for around 4 to 5 minutes more, you can see it will leave the pan in this way. So this is the time when we need to switch off the flame. We don't want to over dry it, otherwise our tikkis will be dry, and if it's not done in this way, they might break as well in the curry. So it's very important we just roast them for around 7 to 8 minutes till they start to leave the pan, and the consistency should be like this. Then I'll transfer it to a plate and use the spatula to spread it in the shape of a cube. Basically it is cut in the shape of paneer pieces that we normally use in Indian curries. So here I have used the spatula after 1 to 2 minutes because it was quite hot. I'll now use my hands. I've applied some oil on my hands, and now I'll use my hands to just pat it and make it smooth. I normally do this process under fan so that the air helps to cool this mixture more quickly, and after it has cooled down, I have used a plate to just flip it over so that I can show you both the sides, and you can see how beautifully my besan mixture has set perfectly, and it is so nicely set that I can even hold it from sides and flip it, yet it will be intact. So this is how it should be, and my besan base has perfectly cooled down, and it is almost perfect to make cut out the tikkis or besan varas, whatever you can call. So before cutting them out, apply some oil on the knife and then start cutting as normally we cut puffies. Make sure you make some small pieces because it will normally absorb water and it can increase in size in the curry. Not much, but yes, they do become tender. So here I have cut medium size cubes from this besan base, and you can see how nicely and smoothly I am cutting this base. So that signifies my besan tikkis have turned out to be perfect. And yes, when you do not have any green vegetable, this is the most exotic veg curry that can be made without any vegetables. And I'll show you one tikki. You can see how smooth it has turned out from all the sides. It's just perfect, binded properly. And once I cook it, I'll also show you how they behave in the curry. So it's done. Now I have heated mustard oil to fry them. I personally prefer the taste of mustard oil in this type of items, traditional items. But if you do not want to use mustard oil, you can also use the regular oil. But for my preference and my choice, I always use mustard oil. Once it's medium and hot, I have added the tikkis and fry them on medium flame for around 6 to 7 minutes. Till this crisps, besan tikkis become golden and crisps. Do not fry them in high heat, otherwise they will turn instantly golden, but the center might remain uncooked. So it's very important we fry them on medium flame. Heat the oil on medium high flame, and then once you add the tikkis, cook them on or fry them on medium flame for around 7 to 8 minutes for one batch. Don't overdo the tikkis, otherwise they may turn dark in color. But yes, this would be perfectly done like this, and I have also fried some batches more, and my tikkis are looking perfect. So now let's prepare the curry. For that, I have taken one large onion paste and some paste of tomatoes and green chilies, two medium sized tomatoes and green chilies, half inch ginger and 10 cloves I have just made paste. And some dry spices here, chili powder 1 teaspoon, Kashmiri red chili powder 1 tablespoon for the lovely color, coriander powder 1 tablespoon, cumin powder 1 teaspoon and turmeric powder. Here I have taken 1.5 teaspoon. And to blend all this, I have taken half a cup of water. So first I'll just mix them in half a cup of water and let them rest for 2 to 3 minutes so that all the dry spices will be absorbed by the water. This is it. Almost everything we have prepared. And now in a large kadhai, I have taken this kadhai and I'll add 4 to 5 tablespoons of mustard oil. And two medium sized potatoes I have taken, peeled them and I'll have cubed them. And this goes in, this gives a lovely flavor to the curry. I just love the potatoes of this curry. So I just need to fry them in high flame for around 2 to 3 minutes. Till the upper surface attains a nice golden color. We don't want the potatoes to be cooked here at this stage, just we need the upper surface to be nice golden brown. So after 3 to 4 minutes on high flame, this is it. In the same pan, I have added few whole spices. One bay leaf goes in, one black cardamom, cinnamon half an inch, green cardamom 2, black peppercorns 3 to 4, and cloves goes here around 3. So once all these whole spices have tempered a bit for around 2 to 3 seconds, I'll add initially the onion paste. Roast the onion paste in medium flame for around 4 to 5 minutes till you can see the raw smell goes out, and the size of the onion paste, the amount it reduces considerably. So once it is done, I'll add the paste of the dry spices that I had made, of the red chili and turmeric and coriander powder. This goes in. So now I need to roast all the spices with the onion paste for around 2 to 3 minutes on medium flame till you can see the oil starts to separate. And once the oil starts to separate, there goes the ginger garlic paste. So now I'll roast all the spices, onion paste with the dry spice paste and this ginger garlic paste till they become aromatic and the raw smell goes away. It will take around 5 to 6 minutes, and you can see the oil starts to separate from sides. Once it attains this stage, I'll add the fried potatoes. And after adding fried potatoes, do not forget to add the oil, the potato oil, that will give the lovely flavor of potatoes. And then the onion and tomato paste that we had made, 3 to 4 tablespoons of water goes in, and salt here I'll add according to taste, so that these potatoes will be nicely stirred with this spices and attend all the goodness of flavors of these spices. So give them a nice mix and reduce the flame to lowest. We have already added 4 to 5 tablespoons of water. Cover it and leave it for around 6 to 7 minutes on lowest flame. And after 6 to 7 minutes, you can see the potatoes have almost cooked around 80%. At this stage, add garam masala around half a teaspoon, and the color of this masala spice paste has changed. That means it has been cooked. You can see, just increase the flame to medium and you can see the oil will start releasing. And once the oil has started releasing, the masala paste is done. To it, I'll add water 2 cups. It depends upon the gravy that you want to have in this curry, but normally little bit more amount of water is added because the besan tikkis will absorb some water. So 2 cups or 2.5 cups is okay. Once the gravy starts to boil, here at this stage I'll add some coriander leaves. Adding coriander leaves at this stage will give more flavor. So just wait till it comes to a nice boil after adding coriander leaves, and then after it I'll add the fried besan tikkis or besan cube that goes in. Make sure when you add the basil to kill, there should be a boil in the gravy. And now just give it a mix. You can adjust salt at this stage. And do not forget to add 2 pinch of sugar or jaggery. That will just balance all the flavors. And now I'll reduce the flame to medium. Cover it and let it just bubble out for around 4 to 5 minutes. And you can see the besan tikkis have almost absorbed some water. At this stage, switch off the flame and just cover it around 50% and leave it for around 15 minutes. And after 15 minutes, the flame was off, yet the besan tikkis have absorbed the water. They have actually immersed in the gravy and yet they have retained the shape and texture. That means our besan tikkis are perfect. And just I'll cut one tikki and show it to you. And you can see how soft it has turned out with a perfect nice consistency and the texture. You can see lovely, and they're just looking like fried pani pieces, but yes, they are made from besan or gram flour. And how beautifully I can cut them at ease. You can see they're so soft, so tender, so flavorful, yet they are intact. So let's serve this lovely besan curry. And you can see the gravy is just perfect, neither too thin nor too thick. So again, it depends upon your choice, and it's just looking lovely, beautiful cubes of besan and coriander leaves to finish this presentation. So one plate full of goodness. When you have nothing to make in green vegetables, try this awesome recipe. And again, I just love the flavors of this besan once they absorb the raw flavors of the gravy. So try this out and let me know how your besan tikki or besan curry turned out. And now it's time for the comment of the day. Today's comment of the day is from Queen Arohi. She writes, I am your new subscriber, ma'am. All your cooking videos are very tasty and yummy, ma'am, which gives very much happy and tasty. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, uncountable thanks. God bless you. Thank you so much, Arohi. Lots of love and uncountable love to you too. Stay blessed and stay connected. And for today's recipe, that's the very unique and tasty besan tikki curry or besan curry, whatever you can call. Try this out and let me know how it turned out. Not forget to follow Sue's Food Corner in Instagram and Facebook. And if you have liked today's video, do give a thumbs up, share with your family and friends. And do not forget to subscribe to my page. See you in next video. Till then, stay safe, love life and happy fooding.